You know, anything over 80,000 plants a year, as the program is now, couldn't be accomplished without the effort of volunteers. And we'll have easily on a weekend in September, we'll have volunteers, maybe a good weekend, a big number, would be 100 plus volunteers. And we do have those weekends, and we have them repetitively, season after season. And it's quite easy on a day like that to plant 18 to 20,000 plants in one day. And when you're looking at the numbers and you're saying you're trying to get 50,000 like we did this year at Sunrise, plant it, and you can do 20,000 in one day with volunteers, it's a tremendous amount of help. I always remind all the volunteers, both for the education volunteer side of it, as well as those who came out, you know, just to get some hard work in and spend many hours during the day, is that the vegetation they plant, the plants they plant, stay. And if we've done our job right as a program, we've picked an area that we can protect, and the vegetation's gonna persist. And potentially, they should be able to come back, you know, 50 years from now and see that same vegetation there, see the same plants growing. And I think that's a huge reward for a lot of our youngest volunteers to think about, you know, that they can come back and see that. And we've had school groups come through and some of the students coming back for their second or even third year, and they'll go and pick out the plants that they planted the year before. And it's great because they get to actually see that I was telling the truth, that their plants survive and they'll actually live. So that's pretty rewarding. But then they're also kind of becoming stewards of the mountain, you know, and of these resources. And I think they carry that with them.